Okay, so now let's just pretend that my hands here are the arytenoid cartilages. Okay, the cricoarytenoid is dorsalis muscle. Its fibers are going to come this way over to attach to the muscular process on the arytenoid cartilage. So when it contracts, it's going to have this kind of a pull. So it's going to pull the arytenoids outward, opening the airway. Okay, now the cricoarytenoideus lateralis, its fibers come up this way. So when it pulls, it's going to cause closing of the airway. Okay, so now let's just say that this is the thyroarytenoideus muscle attaching here to the arytenoid cartilage, and this is the vocal fold. Now the thyroarytenoideus muscle, when it contracts, it's going to pull the arytenoid cartilage ventrally, and it's going to loosen the vocal fold, which will then have an effect on lowering the pitch. It also is going to somewhat close the airway. Now, the more difficult one is the cricothyroideus muscle. So let's just pretend these are the two sides of our cricoid and our thyroid cartilage. We've got on the cricoid cartilage attaching to this surface here, the cricothyroideus muscle, and then it comes up and attaches on this inner surface here. When it contracts, it's going to bring those ventral ends together like this, and in doing this, it's going to put tension on the vocal fold, and so that's going to then increase the pitch.